Hi, parents and students. This is part two of our Welcome Back to School series. And in this screencast, we're going to talk about what a flipped classroom is and give you a little bit of description and intro into it. And I think what students are most interested in finding out is, will this work for me? And is this a good deal? Just like the little bee wonders too. So the key ideas, and remember this week we're trying to model a screencast for you. So every screencast is built on the same components. The first part is always the key ideas. And in this screencast, we're going to talk about a little bit about what the flipped classroom is. Can a student be successful? And very importantly for grade 12 students who are heading off into the great world beyond, can they still get the grades they need for entrance into their university or program of choice for next year? And then how do you do the flipped class? What do students have to do? So I am just wanted to reassure you that I am very aware that at the grade 12 level, you are heading off into the future, and the future does have requirements that you want to be ready for. And I am have those at the forefront of my mind as I enter this year with you and enter into this working relationship with you. And I hope that you can trust that I have your very best interests as you transition off into the future out of our school OKM and to meet the demands that your future will ask of you. So the vocabulary words, again, just reminding you, I'm modeling for you the screencast format. So what is a flipped class? Screencast is what you're watching right now, and that's what you'll watch all year, and these are posted to YouTube. Flex time, this is the word I use to describe the time that I give you in class to do your learning. And as we work together, this time will increase as we get better and better at self-regulating. And I would describe a flipped classroom as a learner-centered and learning-centered classroom, rather than in comparison to a teacher or teaching-centered classroom. And so let's start with what is the flipped classroom. So defined for clarity, a flipped classroom is where the lecture component of the class, so what I used to do in class, the stand and deliver part of what you're used to in class, is now delivered to you through a screencast. And you will watch those at the beginning of the year at home. And then we will change that up. But again, for clarity's sake, a screencast is what I've loaded to YouTube, and I've provided for you a summary note packet that you will utilize when you watch them to summarize the content. So it's just like what you're used to, but we're doing it via YouTube delivery, and we're doing it in another time and another place, and perhaps not all together. It is, however, not an absolute. So this definition is not stuck in cement. It is going to evolve with us and change with us as our skills and our skill set get stronger and broader. So this is a starting point for us this year, but it will change over time as we change. And so how does it work? So you'll go to YouTube, where we've already seen my YouTube channel. You'll find all the screencasts loaded there by unit. Each unit has about no more than 3 screencasts, and each screencast lasts no more than 10, at the outside 11 minutes. Will for each unit be given a packet, and these learning packets have in them the summary notes that you will utilize when you watch the screencast. And this is to help you to identify what you're watching for, to keep your focus, to allow for some interaction between you and the screencast. But further to that, rather than just one-way delivery of content, it is also to give you some time in class to explore the content, to create and have questions about the content, to find answers, then hopefully utilizing the screencast, and then to come back to class and share the answers that you found that we can all benefit from that process. And most importantly at all, we can say, what is the flipped classroom? Where is the flipped classroom? How do I flip class? But most importantly, I'd say the flipped class is you. The flipped class is about you and your learning. And so the flipped class is really about you connecting to, owning, and discovering your process for learning. So what if you don't like it? So we all sometimes start things and we think, oh, this really isn't for me and I really don't like this. But again, I would like to assure you that in this classroom, you're going to be provided many different choices of how you would like to interact with the content and a lot of variety. We will do a variety of topics for each and every unit. So just like when you go to a buffet, there's a little bit something for everything. And hopefully as time goes by, you'll be able to select then the things that suit you and your timetable and your level of commitment and your goals best. So if you don't like it right off the bat, just hang tight. And remember that when you're changing anything, your eating habits, your exercise habits, going to a new place, change and adjusting to how that change makes you feel takes time. So sometimes when we're changing, we get a little bit of anxiety. We feel a little uncomfortable because we're not certain yet of the outcome. And we just have to hang tight to make a decision based on the reality of the situation rather than just reacting to the fact that you're not liking the change. So again, I'm pretty sure that given a chance, you're going to find that it really is going to work for you. So why should you care as the student doing the learning? Well, school can be pretty one size fits all, and we really are not one size fits all people. We are all very different. We all wear different size clothing, eat different things, do different things, bring different skills to the table, and that can be pretty boring after a while. The problem is that over time, you students perhaps have become adjusted and accustomed to that boredom. It's almost soothing to you because you can easily maintain right that disconnection. It doesn't ask you to engage fully. So I'd suggest that over time, hopefully, that if you re-engage with the process and re-engage with what's going on in the classroom, that's going to be a lot more enriching, fun, and exciting. I think also it's going to offer you real skills that you can take out the door from OKM and on into your future, wherever that may be, into the workforce, into university, into an apprentice program. These are skills you controlling your learning and your time and self-regulating your devices. This is going to be a skill that is going to give you success in the long term. It also gives us time as a group. We're a large group of people, and when I stand and I am the blabber monster who blabs all class long, that robs you of collaboration, interaction, time that really is dynamic and exciting, and we want to utilize that time. So for all these reasons, I think for you students, this model is going to offer you a lot more than I could when I was the blabber monster and I stood in the front of the room and really just did nothing but talk, right? So can you, ending off our screencast, can you tell yourself, where are you going to go and watch those screencasts? And hopefully you're saying YouTube. Can you describe one advantage that you maybe are seeing at this moment in time for yourself? Can you describe one thing perhaps that you're feeling a little bit worried about, that you're not sure about? And hopefully we can talk about those in class next day and alleviate those worries. Hope that helped.